In today's video, we will be breaking down how to use Tradovate's trade copier. This is going to be a full tutorial. You can expect to learn how to get started with Tradovate, how to set up the charting platform, how to connect Tradovate and funding companies, placing trades with trade copier. If you've ever asked me about trade copying, I am kind of against it because it can hurt traders more than I think it can help them. But I have a lot of Apex trader funded accounts, and I'm finding it with the four that I have, finding it kind of a pain in the ass to try to trade them and then all the other funded accounts I have with other companies. It's just too much trading to do. Let's go ahead and head over to manage groups, and then you're going to press. All right, so I already have my trade copier set up right here. I'm in a trade. So I have these are evaluation accounts, but I want to set up a grouping for my funded account. Oh, but first we need to click on the right-hand corner there. Come over to here, right? Go to add-ons and make sure that you have all the ones that are free on. So you want to activate group trade and then go to manage groups. And then we're going to do another one. So we'll call this PA accounts. And we're going to push OK. And then now it's saying, which ones do I want to add into here? So the ones that you want to add in, you're going to place over there. So I'm going to place these two, 41 and 42. And then quantity, you can leave that at one unless you want one account to have twice as many contracts. Like if I was to put this on two, it would then put double the contracts. Right, so if I put entered one, it would enter two on this one. If I enter two, it would enter four. We'll just leave it 1-to-1 and then push save. Okay, so now you can go ahead and exit out of this. All right, so now I want to enter a position with my funded account. So I'm going to come over to here. I'm going to click up here and I'm going to click on this one right here. Now, as long as I make sure that I'm on the count, see how I clicked on that group, but it still shows up there. So I need to come up to here and then click on one of these. So 41. So it's a two-step process. You click on the group you created, right? And then you click on one of those accounts inside of that group. So we'll click on PA accounts and then click on one of them that's in the group. So we're going to click on 41. So now I have both of them up there. Now we're going to come to here, right? So we have two accounts in the group, correct? So then if I want to enter with two contracts on each account, I'm going to click on four. And it does not automatically enter bracket order, so you're going to have to do that manually. We're going to go ahead based off of what it does here. If it goes up, then I'm going to have to exit. All right, so I think price is going to probably continue up here. I'm going to go ahead and enter buy market. Now you see how it's, let me zoom this in. Okay, now you see here how it says open P&L, net price, that's my entry price, and then here is the net positions. It says long with an up arrow, so I'm long two accounts, and my net position is two per each, so I'm going to want to put my stop. I'll just put sell for stop loss right there. Now I have a stop loss in the market. Now, if you move this, let's say I wanted to adjust my stop, you would just move it here and then it will move my stop loss for both of these accounts. If I wanted to move it up, then I would just move it up. I don't personally set take profit orders, but if you wanted to, you could go sell for limit up here, right? And then that would sell for there for you. So that's all there is to it. You can't set bracket orders from what I understand. You have to just do it manually. And then if you want to scale out, you would just come to here. Let's say I want to take half of this off. So I would say two, right? And then I believe if I sell two, it will exit one and one. So let's check this out. Once it pushes up here again a little bit more. So there's my entry at buy 2669. Let's see what happens if I push one. Let's see what happens if I sell one. It's saying it must be a multiple of two because I have two accounts here. So I just got stopped out there. You can see how I got stopped out on this one account, but it stopped me out on all of them. So that's good. So now let's say I wanted to buy one contract. You go buy one and boom. So now it's putting one in the market with each account. So whatever number here, you just divide it by how many accounts you have. So let's say, let's put a stop loss in real quick. We'll just say below here. So if you put a buy, if you're in a long position, a buy one, you're going to put a sell to stop there, right? Let's go ahead and go back to the other group here. My other group is right here. To go to that group, I'm going to click on that one. And I'm going to click on one of the accounts in that group, which then brings up these three accounts here. So because I have three accounts, I need to, if I want to enter two contracts, I'm going to push six. And boom, so now it would enter me in. But let's say I wanted to go short here. Boom, now I'm in the market, short six. I would then place my stop, buy six stop there. Now two is on this account. And if you want to, you can check on each account individually. If I wanted to go to here, see, now I can double check to make sure my stop's in there correctly. All right, now let's go back to the PAA ones. And then to be able to look at that, I'm going to go click on one of these that are in the group. The group is these here. There now. So now it went back to this group. You see that? Now let's say I wanted to add on to this because I think it's going to go up or whatever. If I wanted to add on one contract each, push two. All right. It's really simple. You just go to the group. You put which accounts you want in there. You have to multiply it by two. Or multiply this number. So if I wanted to enter two and I had two accounts here, then I would go four contracts. Let's see, buy four. And then I place my stop immediately after I enter, sell four stop. And then it shows up two on each one. And then your P&L that shows up here is going to be for all the accounts in that group. It says 80, but it's only 40 per. I don't think a trade copying is a good idea for everyone. I think if you have multiple funded accounts, go for it. But I think if you're trading one funded account, there's no reason to mix it with your valuations. I think it hurts traders more than it actually helps them. I've helped a lot of traders and I've met a lot that have tried to trade copy and ended up blowing 5, even 10 funded accounts at once. But if you're getting payouts and you're like me and you're getting tired of trading all day, because you have so many different accounts, then it makes sense, right? If I have multiple Apex Trader funding accounts, it's starting to make sense to just copy trade them. I'm going to go ahead and exit these positions I entered in. I'm going to go short, actually. I'm going to go sell market and put my stop up here, buy four stop. And then now my stop's in the market. Now, if I want to go check on my other accounts, I would just go click on this. And then I would go click on one of the accounts that's in that group, which would be here. Now I would go sell market because I have three. Now I have to multiply everything by three, right? 3, 6, 9, but it would be six if I wanted to enter two of each six. Now sell market. Once I have six in there, so there's six, sell market. And then boom, if I want to put my stop in there, boom. And if I wanted to put a take profit, I'll just go six there. And then voila, profit target set, everything's good. I can exit it and it exits on all of them. How do you set up your charts in trading or Tradovate to have it like this? I'll show you guys. You're going to come over to here, add modules. You'll go positions. That's the one that I have in the corner. And then you pick it, you grab it, and then drag it over. And I had it in this full area here, but I'll just do it again. And then there it is. And then you can have other ones in there too. There's lots of different modules, right? If you just click up here, you can look at all of them. You have orders, time and sales, log, legacy chart. Let's see what that is. I'm not sure what that even is. I'm not sure what the difference between a chart and legacy chart is. Someone knows the difference. Can you let me know in the comments? But I'm going to go ahead and take this off of here because I don't want it on there. Now you can see that in my account here, it is green. I'm plus $20, but it says 60 right here. And then if you wanted to have a DOM on here, you go super DOM and then put it wherever you'd like it. You can even move. And once you have these here, you can drag them to wherever you would like them. You could have it up there or you could move it to the side here and have it like that. Then you could have your DOM over here and voila. And then you can also trade off the DOM with these as well. If you want to adjust this positions thing, you can come to your select columns. Let's say I don't want the net price in there. I push save. That way it's easier to see here. I'm actually curious about if my stop loss is going to be put into TradingView now. I'll show you guys real quick how to connect Tradovate to TradingView. We'll go ahead and move my stops. It's not so large, so it's only a couple points. And then we'll go to my PA group. And then now if I want to adjust the PA group, I would click on one of those ones in the PA group like that. And then now I can see my PA group. Here's my stops way up there. We're going to go and move that way back down. So that again, I'm only risking a couple points. And then we're going to head and log out of this one. And then we'll go into TradingView here, log out, and we'll log back into Apex here. And so now you can see I'm short and my stop's even in there. So that is pretty cool. Now I'm wondering if I move this stop, will it move it on all of those two accounts that I have in there? You can like copy trade through TradingView, but you just have to enter via Tradovate. You could do what I just did, pull up, and then if you want to manage the trade via here, I think that is possible. So let's go ahead and test this. Let's move our stop up just a click. It was at 95.75. We moved up to 96.50. Let's go ahead and log back into Apex.
Interesting, it did. It moved it up to 96.50. Let's see if it did it on both accounts. So let's go 4.0.
It's something to note if you adjust the stop via the wrong account. Okay, hold on. This one's at 96 and this one's at 96.50. The one on here is at 96.50. So you can adjust them individually at that point, but once you move it on TradingView, it does not work in a group trade setting. That makes more sense. I got stopped out there. It stopped me out on both accounts. We'll go ahead and go back to our group here, which got stopped out as well. All right, so now, let's say you're not connected to TradingView yet. How do you do that? The first step is in Tradovate, you come up to this here, right here, and go to add-ons, and then click TradingView. Like I said earlier, you're going to want to click all these on that are free, like that, and voila. And then sign out of that. You have to sign out. So you push X, come into here, log out, and then go back to TradingView. And that same username and password you used to sign into Tradovate, you would put it into here on the demo setting, push connect, and then boom, now you're connected to TradingView. If you guys are interested in getting funded, check out my website, it is verified.com. Once you're on the homepage here, if you click right here, it'll take you to the latest discounts. You guys can sign up for my newsletter. You just enter your email there. It only takes 1 second. You just enter and that's it. It has, and then the newsletter that I have, I will be sending out once a week, tips and tricks on how to pass funding evaluations and long, and then the newest and best discounts in the game. Bullnox, 73% off option one, 58% off option two. Apex Trader funding, 71% off of all accounts. Only 1 day needed to pass the evaluation account, meaning if you buy it that day and you pass it the day you get funded after market close, you can start trading immediately. Take Profit Trader has a new discount, which is the best in the game, 40% off, and then no activation fee, so you're saving yourself $150. TopStep Trader, you guys know about them, I'm sure. 50K account for only $50 and so on. Tradedate has a very, very good payout structure from day one. TickTick Trader, the unique thing that I like about them is they have straight to funded accounts. And if you use these codes, you get $100 off for the 50K. But I think overall, Take Profit Trader is my favorite. Their payouts are just so fast and simple. You request them, you get them. I use PayPal. I get them literally 2 to 3 hours later after I request my payout. That makes them above the game. They do have a little bit more rules, but it's always give and take. Apex, less rules. You don't have access to your money from day one. Same thing with Bullnox. If you guys want to learn about how I trade and trade with me, you can sign up for my YouTube membership, which is going to be on my second channel, which is Jared King Trading. And then because I'm already subscribed to it because it's my shit, right? It doesn't have a join button here, but if you weren't, you would push instead see perks. It would say join. You can join there and then you can trade with me live 3 times a week. So you can see here, I traded 6 hours ago. I traded for an hour on stream. And then day before that, I did market analysis, Asia session trading, and then every other day. So every day I'm doing something via live stream. Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays are live trading. And then Sundays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays are market analysis and Asia session trading. I'm straight killing it on stream. Usually I profit anywhere from $1,000 to $2,000. As you can see here, plus 200 or plus 2,000, plus 1,700. I don't always put the number, but if I want people to watch it, I'm like, hey, I think they'll learn a lot from it. Then I go ahead and put the number on there. So you guys can trade live with me and all that. You can sign up for that. And I'll put the link to that in my description. I appreciate you guys. I also have a lot of videos on here about strategies. That's all I've done on this fucking channel is just strategy after strategy. There's a million different strategies and every type of style you can think of. So check it out, guys. I will see you in the chart.